It is weeks like this, moments like this, mornings, days like this, where I'm so grateful to have put in so much work so early on in my life and in my career and in my bass playing and my music that it doesn't take me too long to recover from a complete week off of playing. And yesterday was a little ropey, and today it feels that the sound is back, the feeling is back. It didn't take long just to ease back into it, taking it very slowly, of course, but I'm really grateful for that. And out of that has come a new compositional idea. New set of changes, new melodic idea that I've never played before, just happened across it early this morning. It's about 10:15 now. I've been practicing for hours, which is really good. And it's not completely fluent yet because I'm still having a little trouble moving from here to there. Not that it's a difficult change particularly, but it's not one that's 100% natural yet. And the composition is by no means set in stone, but it's a nice beginning to it. It's a nice starting point. Where is it? There it is. Nice. Morning practice sermon is over. It's time to get on with the rest of the day. All right, first stop of the day will be the racket doctor to get some fresh sticks, fresh racket strung. Awesome morning of practicing. That was so good. Felt so fluid again, and it didn't take long. Love the fact that I can do that. Not that it encourages me to take lots of time off and then scramble to get it back together again, but it's nice that I can take some time off, and I know that I can take some time off, so I'm not always constantly under pressure and constantly having to worry about my chops being in shape or that I have to practice every second of every day. Nice feeling, gotta say. It was not always like that. Got the mains poly in the cross, 44, 41. Three fresh sticks should get me through the next few days of playing. Of course, it's another beautiful day in LA. It's almost 80 degrees, which for December is just rocking. Now it's time to go over here and do battle with Louis. And hopefully it doesn't feel as exhausting as yesterday, and I'm back on the right path to having a little higher level of fitness like I had maybe last month.
Are you filming me? I'm filming you too. Yeah, that's it. And back, let it fall down. Yes, good. Don't get nervous because the camera is here. That's fine. Movie star now. Here we go. Yeah, that's a nice swing. Yeah, much better. Okay, let's take a little break.
Mr. Snapchat glasses.
That's right.
So now you're recording Snapchat?
Now I'm recording Snapchat.
We're recording each other.
Uh-huh.
That's the future, ladies and gentlemen. Snapchat glasses. This is Louis. He's not a bad tennis player, but he is a world-class drummer. I did not win. Louis beat me. But that's okay. The fitness came back, which is awesome. kind of just like the bass playing came back after taking a week off, the time, the sound, the touch and everything, the feel, the fitness kind of came back today after being, after feeling kind of way out of condition yesterday. It only took one hard session yesterday to feel pretty good today about the fitness. Still not 100% by any means, but a lot better. No crashing, no being out of breath, running balls down, feeling in pretty good shape. I think another week of good training and I'll be right back on top again and in great shape. The food thing, the consistency of food thing now being home and being on my schedule is really gonna help as well. So between the nutrition, the exercise, being able to practice music, being able to play tennis, being able to be in the gym, I think it's really the perfect combination. Crazy that it takes time to recover from being away on the road. It definitely takes a concerted effort to recover from traveling for what I do for a living, for being a musician. I never used to pay enough attention to that, to the recovery element of being a musician. So it's nice for that to be in the forefront of my mind now as soon as I get back off the road. Restock the fridge and the pantry and start cooking at home and eating well, exercising a lot. It's not one thing or the other. It's a big kind of machine with lots of moving parts that you have to maintain. It's not just practicing the bass. It's not just eating good. It's not just exercising. It's all of those things combined and more. It is Q&A time. So let's get to it. Andy Palladino writes, I'm digging the vlogs, but I can't leave a question on YouTube for whatever reason. So I was wondering about what I need to start making my own tracks like the ones you do for the vlog. I have a MacBook and I wanted to get that little Akai keyboard you have, but I don't know what else I need to get started. Really simple. I have the MacBook Pro and I have the little Akai keyboard. For composition so far for the blog, I've mainly been using Apple Loops. In terms of all those grooves you hear, I've been chopping them up a little bit, processing them, compressing them, distorting them. I try not to use just the straight stock loop. I try and do something original with it. That's always the goal. But that's all I've been using. I do use a plugin by Spectrasonics called Keyscape. Amazing plugin. Just so many great keyboard sounds. My sample library is, I gotta say, pretty weak in terms of what it used to be when I was doing a lot of production, doing a lot of writing. So that's something I'm working on building up myself right now. And that's just a matter of going out there and figuring out what you hear, what you like, and getting those samples, getting those plugins to use within a piece of software like Logic. I like Logic. I've always used Logic. I've used it since the beginning, since 3.2 or whenever it was, or even those beta versions, 10, 12, 13 years ago, whenever Logic was first coming out, when it was made by eMagic. So I've always been a Logic fan, always used plugins and soft synths and all those kind of things. So that's basically what I'm using for this vlog soundtrack and for all my programming and pre-production whenever I'm in composition mode. Yesterday's vlog produced a lot of comments and a lot of questions. Nick M asks, what do you think of bands like Tesseract and Animals as leaders? Recently heard your podcast with Tosin. Excellent interview. Thank you. That was a lot of fun to do. Since you have such a wide musical taste, I'm interested on your take on modern metal / progressive music. Would you ever do a project in that realm if you were offered? Totally. I mean, you know, when you look at someone like Tosin Abasi, for instance, that's like a force of nature when it comes to that style of music, that instrumental, almost classical music, the way it's composed and the way it's put together and the way, I've never seen them live, but I have checked out a bunch of videos online, the way it's performed, it's amazing. It's quite a feat, and to be able to do that night after night, I have a lot of respect for those guys. I hadn't heard of Tesseract before, but before I did this Q&A, after reading your question, I did go check them out on YouTube, and a little different from Animals as Leaders, obviously, because they have a vocalist, and I like the vocalist very much, actually. One thing I will say about both of those bands is sonically, they totally have a thing, like a unique thing, and the way they're recorded is very clear, so I appreciate that about the music. You get to hear all of the compositional elements, all of the different layers really clearly, so I appreciate that about that music and about those two bands. Would I do a project in that realm if I was offered? Absolutely. I mean, good music is good music, and if I'm into it, then I'm into it. There are no two ways about it. Like, I like Animals as Leaders. If the opportunity arose to play with those guys or to play in something similar to that, absolutely. I would totally dig the challenge, dig the musicality of the other people who, you know, to operate on that level as someone like Tosin does has a lot of respect from me, for sure. It would be a really interesting project. It would be a lot of fun doing the work to learn all that material. You know, I think that would be a total blast. Funkmaster for Two writes, "Hi Janek, hope you've had a cool Christmas." Yes, I did, thank you. I was just wondering, that major minor bit you've just shown us, is it available as an easy to learn lesson, or could you do a slowed down version for us mere mortals? Many thanks, Robert." I'm pretty sure you're talking about yesterday's vlog, where I was going through the changes of time stand still. There's a little too much feedback on the delay there. Where I was playing minor major, minor major arpeggios and augmented arpeggios over the changes of that tune. It's really very simple. I too am a mere mortal. I think what you said was meant as a compliment. I appreciate that very much, but don't think of me as any different from you in terms of that. It's just hard work in terms of my facility with how I move through those changes, but the concept is very, very simple. And what I was, first of all, what I did in yesterday's vlog is a lesson on videobasedlessons.tv. So when I do put snippets of me playing and me explaining a few things in the vlog, for the most part, those things are parts of bigger lessons that I upload and explain in kind of great detail for the members at videobasedlessons.tv. Becoming a member of that website is one way of having all that material, having a much more detailed explanation, and definitely taking it at your own pace. The vlog is not really, this is not really about teaching bass, but of course, practicing and talking about the bass comes up every day in my routine, so that's gonna be in the vlog a little bit. In terms of the concept of what I was doing there, those chords in that tune are just minor seven chords and major seven chords. The whole tune is written around those. So B flat minor seven. And somebody here, John Gear, wrote, "Thanks Janek for the fantastic vlog." You are more than welcome. And John Gear gave a whole breakdown in the comments of yesterday's vlog of the chord changes, which are blah, 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 blah. Perfect, yes. Chord changes are totally right. It is from my first album, Mystery to Me. It's song number five. It's called Time Stand Still. It's a very good breakdown of that. And he also puts, "For a complete transcription of this song, it's in my book, Songs and Solos," which it is. So thank you, John Gear, for writing all of that information there. If you want to read that, go to yesterday's vlog and you can see that in the comments. But back to the minor and the major thing, really very simple. You play upper minor arpeggio, so one, minor, three, five, and then you go to the major seven, to the one. And we're doing it in two octaves, or I was doing it in two octaves, so. Okay, that's the minor major portion of it. And then on the major seven chords, I was just turning them into augmented major seven chords. So root, major third, sharp five, major seven, one. I'm doing this in D, for instance. So root, major third, sharp five, major seven, one. And I was doing it in two octaves, so up I go again to the next. Octave. That's it. Okay, John Hallam asks, "Have you ever tried skyr yogurt? It's supposed to be very high in protein and low in fat. I'm not sure on the sugar content though. I will check that out. I have not tried it, but I'm all about high protein, low sugar, and that sounds like an awesome concept." Okay, Ephraim Flores writes, "I follow Bob Reynolds and your vlog. One thing I notice is Bob shows his family and how he balances business and family. So my question is, how do you balance your time with your wife and work? I know it is hard, but it's always good to get advice from other musicians." Well, that's a real tough one. I don't have a wife anymore. I am not married. I recently got divorced. And I think part of that, in fact, I know part of that was from not doing a good job of balancing work and family. That's a massive challenge. And it's tough to talk about. I don't have an answer for it. There are massive amounts of regret there for sure. And it's been a tough 12 months or so while this has all been going on. I haven't talked about it at all. This is the first time I've talked about it in public, I think. And I don't have too much to say about it other than that is the situation right now. And I was on the fence about asking. I've been asked several questions in the vlog and all over the place, online, social media, about that, and, you know, why am I in a new place, and, you know, where are my dogs, and where's my wife? So I guess that kind of answers that, and it totally sucks. And she was without a doubt the most incredible woman I've ever known. And I miss I miss that life a lot. I miss my dog and miss a lot of things, you know, the support and the nurturing and the relationship element of it, and knowing you have someone so close to you that understands everything about what you do and has been there from the very beginning. You know, it was 15 years we were together. That's a huge loss. That's a huge hole now in what I do and in my ability to do what I do as well as I've been able to do it over the past decade and a half or more. It is very mentally and psychologically difficult to deal with. I guess the question maybe should be, not now that I'm not married, is not how do I balance my work and my wife, but how do I balance my work and my well-being and my mental well-being. I mean, you see in the vlog, I go to therapy every week. I do Skype sessions with my therapist when I'm on the road, and that helps a lot. That really helps a lot, and I'm doing a lot better than I was, that's for sure. And it's just one day at a time. That's all anyone can do. That's all any of us can do. That's all I can do. I know that. And I take it one day at a time and work as hard as I can on making it better and on being better at all of those things, you know, and trying not to make the same mistakes in the future. And it's far more complicated than that and complex. I'm not going to go into it. But as that pertains to the question in terms of the balance of work and family, yeah, I don't think I did a good job at all. And maybe I'll be able to talk about it a little more in the future. It's tough for me to talk about now for sure. But yeah, hate to end the Q&A on a sad note, on a downer like that. But that's the reality. Sometimes it's not all fun and smiles all the time. So yeah, one day at a time. That's probably the best advice I've been given and the best advice I can give anyone else possibly going through the same situation I am. And that is it for today's Q&A. ¶¶